So in today's video, I am going to help you create some better looking or engaging TikTok videos or Instagram reels about motorcycles. Normally, short format content is not something that I'm a huge consumer of. I better like the long format content. That is also why I create YouTube videos. But I have found myself finding TikTok videos and Instagram reels about motorcycle more and more fun and creative. And the best part is that you can do it with a DSLR or mirrorless camera that I use, or a 360 camera, action camera, even your iPhone, which is the camera people use the most. Because here it's not about the quality, but more about the creativity. So therefore, I have created some tips, tricks, concepts, ideas in this video so you can start creating your own. Let's go. The first concept we are going to work with is the classic jump on your bike sequence. It is probably one of the most easy ones to do, but if you put a little bit of thought and effort into it, you can really create this seamless transition in between the two clips that we are going to use in this concept. But there are some small things that you have to consider when filming an effect like this, and the first one is that you are going to need a location. You could do it in your garage, on the street, but if you go that extra mile, you are going to stand out from the crowd and therefore also get a lot more traction and engagement to your Instagram reels or TikTok videos. Because, huge disclaimer, you are not the only one going to do this effect. It has been done before and it is going to be created again. So therefore, go the extra mile and stand out from the crowd. In the first location, I found this awesome parking facility, and for some reason there are just a lot of texture and levels also is going on inside a parking facility. But the idea of this video is that you just stand still on the ground, jump, and when you land, the bike is going to pop in underneath you. A very, very cool effect. Next up is when you have to film an effect like this, you're going to need a tripod. But again, it doesn't matter what camera you use. I use my mirrorless Sony because I really do like the quality that I get out of that with a very, very awesome lens with a lot of bokeh. But you can just use your phone, and you don't even have to use a tripod. You can just place your phone on the ground if that's the only possible way you can do it. That works fine. It just has to stand 100% still. And the reason why it has to stand still is because that you are going to do a raw cut in between two clips. So therefore, everything has to be in the exact same place as the first clip into the second clip. A little thing you can think about is if you're doing it outside, you should do it when it's fully sun or fully overcast, because if there are clouds on the sky, it will go change the light. So it can actually happen that the first clip is more light than the second clip, and then you're going to have this change in light in a snap, and we don't want that. And that is actually why I chose a parking facility, because in there the light is almost the same all the time. After you have set up the camera, you just press record, and the first thing you're going to do is the jumping scene. And the only thing you have to do is just find a spot on the ground you can find again when you have to get your motorcycle in, and then just jump. If you want to go the extra mile again, then think about the position you're going to seat on your motorcycle, so it actually looks like it is popping directly in underneath you. Because it can look a little bit sketchy if you're jumping straight and then sit like cramp on a motorcycle. So when you jump, have a little bit of the position you have on your motorcycle in the air, because then the transition is going to look seamless. Next up is filming yourself landing on the bike. You can just sit still, but I wanted to look like that I was actually jumping on the bike. So what I did is that I parked the motorcycle on the exact same spot, and then I just raised a little bit above the seat, and then just, what can I say, drop down in the motorcycle, so it looked like that I jumped onto the bike, and then have this bouncy effect, because it all going to benefit the transition. So it looks like real magic. But again, you don't have to do this, but go the extra mile. It just looks so much better. And then last but not least, you are going to find a piece of music with a huge drop. And what that means is that after a build up in the music, there is just a lot more power and feelings into the music. And it's really hard to describe, but let me try show you the difference in just doing it with a piece of music and then on a drop in the music. And this is exactly why giving your music a thought is also going to be beneficial for the overall look of your video. Because of copyright claims, I can't show you what trending music I would use in this transition, but the talk about trending music I am going to cover later in this video. The nice thing about this effect or transition is that you can do a ton of variation. You can do it where you jump and then the bike drives in underneath you, but even more cool, if you're running on a road, jump, and then the bike comes, and then you do this hard cut transition, it can also look extremely cool. Try to look at this example I did right here. So what I did is that I just placed my camera on a tripod on the side of the road, and then I recorded a clip where I run out to a specific spot on the road, and then I did a little jump, and again here I went the extra mile with filming it in 120 frames per second. That means that I can slow the footage down, then it just create this more dramatic effect. And then the second clip is just a classic flyby where I hit the spot where I landed with my feet, so the transition is going to be seamless again. The next effect we are going to create is the walk to ride effect. This effect is probably the most easy one to film, but you are going to use some sort of editing software with a basic crop tool in it. But the idea of this video is that you're going to need something in the middle of the frame that splits the frame in two. And in my case, I was using a sign on the road. And then you just walk into the frame from one side, and then after the sign, you are driving on your motorcycle out of the frame again. And again, you just need to place your camera on a tripod so it's standing still. And then you're again going to find a location where there isn't too much noise in the background that can change. Again, here I have filmed it in slow motion just to, first of all, make the clip a little bit longer, because if you just walk and drive, then it would be a very short film. So I have filmed it in slow motion. You can also do that on your iPhone. And then again, make sure if you're outside, don't get interrupted by a cloud that is changing the light, because in this situation, you are going to show both clips at the same time. So if there is a lighting difference, you are going to notice it immediately. But in my case, I opened up Premiere Pro, and it would really amaze me if you couldn't find an app for your iPhone or Android that could do the same thing as this. But in here, I am going to line up my footage, mark exactly where I begin to walk behind the sign. And on the other clip, I'm going to mark exactly where the bike starts to show on the other side of the sign. Then I lay the clip on top of each other, and then adding the crop effect to the top clip, which in this case is the clip with the bike. And then I line up the crop exactly where the sign is. Then I add a little bit of feather so the line isn't as harsh, and then bam. A really, really cool looking wow effect that actually makes people stop scrolling on your phone, maybe watch it again, and that is exactly what you want to happen when doing a TikTok or Instagram reel, standing out from the crowd and make people watch it again, so the engagement is going to be better. Better engagement, better performance. The third concept we're going to create is the show-off type of content. Social media is often just showing off good sides of life, and then not so much about the bad stuff. But that doesn't mean that you should feel guilty or anything. We can still produce some good looking, amazing content about our lovely bikes. So the most easy one to do that doesn't require a skill set other than you just standing in the frame looking cool as hell with your motorcycle. Again, find a nice location, and here I'm using the parking facility as before. and then just film yourself from different angles with and without the bike. And when you're filming the bike with your hands and not filming yourself on the tripod, then create some movement with your phone or camera just to make the video more living. Then you're just going to find a trending song on TikTok or Instagram, and then you edit all of the clips to the beat of the music or even the melody you can use as well. And if you're not sure when and how to do it, just listen to the music. It has this boom, 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 and then just clean cut it every time there. And then you have created this fast pacing looking film about yourself and your motorcycle. It can also be a nice way to film a beautiful location or even a sunset just by showing your motorcycle and yourself and maybe the location. You can go into my Instagram to see exactly what I did and which song I used because that was trending at the moment, and then see how I actually got 300 likes in only 40 minutes. And I only have 500 followers on Instagram, so this is not about how many followers you have. This is about how the content is looking. So the last thing we are going to talk about is trending music. Due to certain circumstances, I can't show you the trending music in this video because I don't want to have a copyright claim on my back today. But if you just use 2.5 minutes on the platform, you will find it out for yourself pretty quickly. And what I do, I actually just go onto Instagram, then I search for the hashtag motorcycle, click on reels, and then just watch all the reels there is, and then you'll see for yourself how many times some of the song is used again and again and again and again. And then you can click on it and then just press use song, and then you're there. Because when using trending music on both platforms, it will do good to your engagement but also be beneficial for the algorithm for Instagram or TikTok to share your content with a lot more people. That is just how it works. So that was it, guys and girls. Go out, create content, have fun, be legal, and don't stress if your content doesn't go viral. Just remember why we do all of this content in the first place. Having fun. Don't forget to like this video, subscribe if you aren't already, and if you're new here, welcome. It is so nice to see you. I hope you can use some of these tips to something, and please head all of your reels my way so I can see how you created them. You can just tag me in the post or just DM it to me. I would love to see what you have created. See ya.